Assalamu alaikum. Now we're going to be doing two tutorials. The first one I'm going to do in English, and it's going to be for this designer suit. It comes with all the relevant pieces, and what I'm going to be doing is using a pre-existing dress as my template or as my sample, okay? And there was a couple of questions posted on how to use a previous dress as a template rather than taking complete measurements. Now this is a very easy method if you are sewing for people, and it stops the need for continuously measuring different, you know, specified measurements and so on. So you can go off an existing template. Now it doesn't have to be a perfect fitting a suit, because the fitting we're actually doing initially, we're just doing the cutting, and then we're going to do finer touches as we go in along, so that it's more perfected as we go on to sewing, as long as it's not overly lousily stitched. A lot of people often complain that I don't have a good template. Oh, you have to press it really hard, and you have to be quiet when I'm talking. We don't have a good template, and we don't know how to work off a template because we don't have a good fitting dress and so on. It doesn't have to be a perfectly fitted, because we're going to do the fitting finally according to our own measurements. So at the moment we're doing an initial cutting, and it's going to be based on this dress. Okay, so the dress that we're making is this one.
Can you open the red one now?
It comes with several pieces. No, I can't open. You're going to have to go outside and play, okay? Stop disturbing me. So, the initial two pieces are these. That's the front and the back. And then it's got this. This we can leave to a side. And that's the trousers. So, we can leave that to a side. We can leave all the pieces to a side, because at the moment, all we're doing is just using the two front and the back pieces just to cut this out from now. Okay, so this is the front of the dress, and what we're going to do is fold this in half. Preferably do it on the wrong side, because then if you've got any markings, you can actually, they're not visible on the right side of the material. Now this particular fabric has embroidery running along the center. So what we've got to do is we've got to center this, and we've got to make sure that the embroidery is central. Now you can do it slightly to a side if your size is a little bit smaller, but if your size is big. Now often these pieces are not very they're not symmetric, and they also sometimes have a little bit of a deviation in the fabric as well, meaning that you know, they're not balanced out, and also you may have a certain amount left at the bottom of one side, so they may not balance out. So you've got to do the best that you can. Try and work on it so that it's all you know, parallel, like there's no you know, the fabric's not lying on a slant. So even if you have to take more of the excess out, so I've laid these two on top of each other, and what I have is the under fabric has about that much more space of embroidery left to the side than the top fabric. But you know what, since I'm going to be chopping most of this away anyway, it's not going to make any difference. Also, if I even it out on the one side, it deviates it on the other side, so it doesn't matter. Since I'm going to be cutting, what I need to do is I need to focus that, you know, the ending of this is all running parallel, so that it hasn't got like a you know, slant, because that's what ultimately, that's what we've got to avoid. And that sometimes happens in fabrics that are embroidered with like straight lines, and the line may fall on the one side, it might fall towards the downside, and on the other side it might. Oh no, your finger's hurting.
Yeah.
Oh, and your face is hurting as well. You know what you need to do? You need to go upstairs and wash your face, because look, you've got a sore there, and it's going to end up getting more sore. Okay?
Yeah.
So go upstairs and wash your face.
Should I take my coat off here and then I'll go, yeah?
Okay then. You can come back and
I want to take my coat off.
Wash your hands and your face and then come back.
Okay? Yes, and that's...
Are you going to be able to wash it yourself?
Yeah.
Okay.
Daddy, could you just open the red one?
No, Naya.
Why?
You're not supposed to have too much. Okay, so once we've done that, we're going to half our chilies. And after straightening it out, lay it absolutely parallel, making sure that this ending is matched to the end of the dress. So we're going to be marking out the outer line. I'm going to do this fairly towards the top. I want to add as much length as possible to. Now, it may take you a little while just to even it all out and to get all the thingies out of this. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to rough mark this. And the way we're going to rough mark this is here is where the embroidery ends. So basically what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be making the chemise almost, you know, I'm leaving like an inch of a margin here and I'm marking it about an inch outer side of the stitching of the dress. And you know, the curving out, I'm just curving it out to sort of like the shape of the existing dress. Now where we're gonna, here on the armhole, what we're going to do is leave at least a finger and a half past the seaming mark for the sleeve. So the armhole actually ends here, and what we've done is so the armhole curves around here and it ends here. What I'm doing is this is where the armhole ends. Now, if I mark it according to this, then what's going to happen is when I seam, my armhole will fall below that. Now, I've got to leave the seaming on the top side of this so that when I leave this excess is my seaming, and my end seaming is going to fall on this line. So we're not going to go below, but we're going to go reverse, the opposite side. So we're going above the seaming. And then here again, this is the marking for the neckline.
Now,
depending on what you're doing, what kind of neckline you're making, this one has. Yeah, this has a high back neckline. So what we have is the neckline on this is a cut neckline, but because we're going to have a high back neckline, there's not going to be any cut. So again, and also this is a deeper cut neckline, we're going to leave at least an inch. This, we only need it about 2.5 inches wide. And then sloping on the shoulder, again, we want this above the cutting of the neckline. A shoulder line, and this we want it blending in, and then here we want it slightly on the outer side of the armhole marking. So this above, and then this on the outer side, and this we're going to curve and blend in for the armhole. So now we're going to come back to this because at the moment we're rough cutting this. We're going to finish the dress, we're going to prepare everything, and we're going to come back to these measurements. This is a rough cutting. So at the moment what I've done is rough marked it, and I'm going to do a rough cut on the whole of this dress. And then once we've done all the attachments and all the pieces, and you know, it's we're going to give it shape. So don't worry about shape as yet. Now also, It's got quite a bit of unevenness at the bottom. So what we're going to do is this unevenness, we're going to take it out.
Daddy.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, you a clever boy.
So. Clip my body.
So this is like a rough template of the dress, and what we need to do is add all the relevant pieces onto this, press it, and then give it shape on the final marking. Now, according to this, what I'm going to do is cut the back of the dress also. Now, if we look on the back of the dress, again, this has embroidery, which there is a certain amount of fabric that's left on the outer side. So, again, we can't do it. We have to do it more towards the center. And also, we want the pattern to fall more symmetric than anything else. You know, you want the... So, the center of this is here. And again, we're going to use the cut out template. We're going to place it on top and try and do these individually rather than doing them together, because it will help you to eliminate any mistakes. When you place them on top of each other, you don't know where the patterns are falling, and you're more likely to end up making a mistake. So do them individually. It might take you just a little bit longer, but it's worth making that little bit of a mistake, taking that time rather than making that mistake. Now, there was one thing I forgot. You know, when I was mentioning that the back of the dress, this actual dress is going to have putty, but it doesn't matter, because we're going to, the back of the dress is the print one, which I actually initially forgot. So we're going to use this as the outer line.
It's finished.
Oh.
I think so. You have to get it out, drink it up to get it out.
Oh, go on then. You can just drink it out then. No, you don't want to get any more.
No, that lily so enough to wash my hands again.
No. Okay, so that's the dress done. Now, next thing, the major problem a lot of viewers have is the armhole. And basically what you've got to bear in mind is this is the armhole, and the sleeve that you could cut has to marry into this armhole. It has to fit in. And so if we look at and if we measure what this armhole is, you'll get an idea. Now, the armhole on this particular dress, you've got a length of 7.5 inches. In length, and crosswise we've got it at 4 inches. So you've got a marking of a 7-inch length and a 4-inch cross, and then this is curved out. So basically that's the cut for the sleeve. Now what you've got to bear in mind is this is going to fall below when you seam it, and also we're going to fine tune this once we've done all the attachments and placed the neck and so on. So it's better to cut it smaller than cut it too deep and then try and eliminate mistakes that you've gone and made. Okay, so anyway, watch the next video when I explain how to do a cutting of the sleeve, because what I've got to work out with this dress is what is the sleeve, because at the moment I'm in a bit of a confusion on what the sleeve is, and I think it's coming from the plain fabric, which is the trouser fabric. So we may have to come back after the cutting of the trouser to make the sleeve. Gigi.